Episode for you guys, and here we are back again, where this is going to be a monastery around Cape Town. Different monasteries that we've covered, lot of places where Kampung Monastery to Pulahari Monastery, you name it, and we've been to a lot of monasteries around Cape Town. This is another monastery that we are here at exploring today, and today being the 10th of March 2018, where the love for travel gets you to different other places. This is one of the places that you really must check out if you're around the Halchowk area. What we are talking about is the red, blue and green flag, which you can see on the outside. A view of Shermu, which looks as beautiful as it can get. It is the backside of the view that we are talking about. And also, with all of this, this place is not that easy to get to. This area has about 4 to 5 monasteries, and right now, where we are, what we are talking about, took us a little while to find out about this place. So you gotta go around the Halchowk side, ask for this monastery, the red monastery, and after about some turns, you'll reach here in 10 minutes of time from the Halchowk. And the city looks really beautiful. The city is jam-packed right now, and the monastery right now that we are, it is gonna be an amazing time. And northwest of Bonpo Monastery, and while we're talking about this monastery and place, it is there where there are a lot of monks around the area, and they're doing their own prayers while these prayers are going on. This was established back in 1977, and especially to preserve the Bonpo culture and religion outside Tibet. So this is why this monastery was formed back then. And right now with Sachin, I'm having a great time while we go and explore the yellow monastery. The other monastery is what we're going to explore. So two monasteries in a day, and here there are rooms for the monks to be staying at too. The prayers were going on, and a lot of stuff that was happening around the place. And while talking about the story of this modern Tibetan Norbustu monastery, it was when Yongjing Rinpoche traveled from Menri Monastery, India, to Swayambhu near Kathmandu, which was in the search of land. Thank you so much. Stay tuned while we get you more of travelogues, while we get you to a place which has never been explored before by the locals, by the people who are on this place. Thank you so much.